Hey guys, Katie here, and today I am reviewing The Stone Gods by Jeanette Winterson. This is a book that is labeled fiction or literary fiction, but is actually, I believe, science fiction. The premise is super science fiction-y, if that's a word. I have a quote from Jeanette Winterson about that, but I'll get back to that later. First, I'll tell you a little bit about it, and then we'll go from there. The Stone Gods is a book written in four parts, and it mostly follows a person named Billy in different situations and time periods. It's a really complex idea, the premise, I think, is, and I think I'd be giving away too much if I got into too much detail about what happens, but I will say that the world that Billy lives in the beginning of the novel is, you know, fancy future and everything is available for you. There's no money. There are robots that are just like human, one in particular. Despite that, there are a lot of problems with the society. For example, nobody is ugly anymore because of genetic modifications and stuff like that. Everyone's beautiful, so the sex that they're wanting to have is becoming crazier and crazier, which means that disgusting things are happening. Like, one in particular, a woman wants to fix herself at the age of 12 because her husband is a disgusting pedophile. There's a lot going on there, especially I think the most important aspect that's happening is their world, Orbis, is dying, basically. They've destroyed it. I think that the most important thing about basically everything that's being said in this book is that it's all relevant to what we're going through now. Climate change, the way we treat other people, you know, the way we treat animals. In The Stone Gods, there is a Robo-Sapiens. Her name is Spike, and she's just like a human, and she's supposed to be smarter even, but despite that, she's basically treated as a sex toy on this, you know, space trip that she takes to another planet with a bunch of men. So, future doesn't sound very good, and it also doesn't sound too far off from where we could be one day. That was like constantly just mind-blowing to me, and that alone I think makes it worth a read, because there are a lot of things that are happening right now that we're causing, and these are all things that have already happened that they're already seeing the consequences of in The Stone Gods, which I think is part of the reason that Jeanette Winterson wrote the book. Some other interesting things about The Stone Gods: the ambiguity of Billy's gender at the beginning of the book. It's a really interesting concept, idea, something to look at in a book that I think, you know, is important, especially considering all of the issues that we have facing up to the fact that gender and sexuality are both not set, that, you know, you can be anything, anyone, you know, you can love anyone you want. These are all things that I think we're trying to learn now that have already been learned in The Stone Gods. It's completely after the fact that they've been through that, and now, you know, does it matter if you're straight or if you're gay or you're bi? It doesn't matter. Everybody assumes that everybody does what they want to do and is who they want to be. Back to the question of genre. There is a part of the book that doesn't really take place in the science fiction-y future. Actually, there are two parts. But still, the majority of the book takes place in the future and is very much in line with most of our science fiction ideas and, you know, tropes and things like that. But I do want to read what Jeanette Winterson said on the topic. I found this on her website, and she says, "People say to me, so is The Stone Gods science fiction? Well, it is fiction, and it has science in it, and it is set mostly in the future, but the labels are meaningless." I read a couple of reviews just trying to, like, kind of get my bearings straight, but the writer of the review was criticizing Jeanette Winterson for not allowing her book to be categorized as science fiction. And I think that's something that maybe in the future of publishing, or just, you know, the world of readers, that maybe we need to face. Something can be science fiction, and it can also be literary fiction. It's totally fine. It can be categorized however, and I sort of agree with Jeanette Winterson that it's, in some ways, it's not cool to put everything into a little box and then, you know, let it be there, because some books are more than just one thing, you know? Some books are science fiction, fantasy, and mystery, but we don't worry about that. But on this topic, is it science fiction, or is it regular fiction or literary fiction? We're kind of stuck. I think science fiction, personally. I would say this book is actually really depressing. It's very much about the dying planet, what we've done to it, what we've done to each other, how we treat people. You know, our priorities are completely screwed up in the future. You know, everything's wrong. It's just bad in general. It's very much the conversation of what happens if a corporation takes over where the government was and why that's bad. There's so much to really think about in this book, and it's really thought-provoking, basically. I think that's all I have to say about this. I know it was a little weird, but I tried to cover everything. Honestly, every time I turned the page, I was like, oh my gosh, what is happening? Like, surprising, you know, enjoyable, thought-provoking, and at times, really fun. It's worth a shot. I'm gonna link below Steve Reed's book's review, because his review is the reason why I really wanted to read this book. And of course he has fantastic taste, so check his review out too if you're interested. And other than that, I hope that you enjoy it if you choose to read it. If you have read it, leave some comments below, let me know what you thought. And I will see you guys later. Bye!